Well, if you have been putting off taking good care of yourself, this next story might convince you not to wait another minute. That's because every 3 minutes, someone dies from a stroke. Nearly 500,000 people will have a stroke before they turn 50 years old. Well, tonight, we're going to meet one woman who defied the odds, the best friend who helped save her life. And Margaret Johnson joins us now to bring us that story.
Well, Cameron, we talk about miracles, and certainly this one has to be one of those.
You may. Nice to meet you.
52-year-old Cynthia Mack appears to be a picture of health, but 18 months ago, she nearly died from what her doctor calls one of the worst strokes anyone can have, a blood vessel ruptured in her head.
When people have a re-rupture, often as high as 50% of those people die in the field and they never make it back to the hospital.
Amazingly, with her head pounding, Mack drove 20 miles down Business 40 to her home in Clemens, stopping only to get pain medicine, went to bed, turned around, drove another 20 miles to the doctor's office, then to a scan, before being rushed to the hospital by ambulance.
It was amazing to me because if you ask me now how I got home, I couldn't tell you. I have to say that I believe in angels, and so I believe angels were guiding me at that point, because I have no recollection.
Lucky for Cynthia, her best friend, Dr. Cherie Chase, ironically head of the stroke department at Forsyth Hospital, was still on duty. Chase remembers the phone call about the patient on the way.
I called the radiologist back and I said, what's the name of that patient that you just told me about? And when he said her name, I thought the bottom of my world would just, you know, fall out from under me. One of the things that she said to me when she first got off the ambulance is, am I going to die? And it's tough to look a friend in the face and not know the answer to that question right away.
The worst now behind her, Mack joins other stroke survivors for a reunion as they all learn more about taking care of themselves after a stroke.
It's been a struggle, but I could not help but come to back here to just, you know, thank the people that helped me. When you get a second chance at life, you want to remember everything about that.
Dr. Chase reminds anyone who thinks they may be having a stroke to get help immediately.
You know, I'm the medical director of the stroke program, but my best friend drove herself to the doctor's office. And so one of the things that we always tell people is to call 911. Imagine what would have happened if her aneurysm had ruptured while she was driving. It could have killed her and potentially killed many lives around her.
What are the odds of that? And Cynthia Mack spent 3 weeks in intensive care. She has some memory problems. On the day she had her stroke, all of the elements lined up in her favor.
I'm glad it turned out the way it did, though, aren't
yeah,
you?
All right.
Thanks a lot, Margaret.